Item number 21, county attorney.
Mr. Chairman, members of the board, item number 21 is an amendment to an IGA that was entered into between Forsyth County, Forsyth County Sheriff's Office, and the Forsyth County Board of Education back in September of 2010, wherein the sheriff and the school district primarily, who were the primary parties to this agreement, agreed to a school resource officer program, wherein the sheriff's office would provide 5 school resource officers to various schools in the Board of Education, in the Board of Education jurisdiction. Subsequent to that, in July, the sheriff entered into an amendment to that IGA. And the reason, I think all of the moving parts of the IGA remain the same, except the sheriff and the Board of Education wanted to provide 2 more school resource officers for a total of 7. The funding was also important. One of the funds for one of the school resource officers was going to be made by direct appropriation from the Board of Education. The other was going to be by a grant of land, which is actually on your next agenda item, at Chestnutty Elementary School. So the Board of Education, in other words, to fund an additional school resource officer, basically issued the sheriff's office a license to put a structure for their horses, for their mounted patrol at Chestnutty. So that's how they're funding this. And you can see in our agenda packet, it's a very short addendum. It's 1 paragraph. And actually, the Director of Finance brought this to my attention, and with good reason. We never approved this. And the sheriff's office and the school district did, but quite frankly, to modify a tripartite agreement, you need to have all parties to the agreement approve it. And so we need to approve this, is the bottom line. What I would call this is a ratification. I'm not asking that it be time sensitive, but if you can get comfortable with this, it just needs to go on the next consent agenda. And again, it has basically 2 moving parts. It adds 2 school resource officers. It funds 1 by direct appropriation for education. The second one is funded by the license on the elementary school.
Sure. What happens if we don't choose to do the part of it for the land trade out for his horses?
Well, that's going to be something we'll have to think about. If the board does not want to sign off on the next addendum, then that necessarily, or the next agreement, it necessarily implicates this one. You know, I'll tell you, the other agreement, I think we need to go there, so I'm just going to go ahead and go to the next agenda item to at least discuss it tangentially because it's related to this one. The other agreement is basically a use agreement of property at Chestnutty Elementary School, wherein the sheriff is going to construct and fund and obtain building permits to put this mounted patrol, I guess it's a horse stable, is quite frankly what it is. And ordinarily I would be comfortable with the sheriff being able to independently contract with the school district because the sheriff as a constitutional officer has that authority, except for the fact that there are indemnity obligations with respect to the sheriff to the Board of Education, wherein the sheriff is basically saying that in the event of there's an issue, a liability situation, some sort of damage or harm, that they will agree to indemnify the Board of Education. Well, the only entity that provides indemnity is us. And of course, the sheriff is covered under the Forsyth County liability policy. So therefore, I think we need to approve this, if you're getting me. So that's the next agenda item. Now, if you want to go back to item 21, I think Commissioner Levant appropriately highlighted the fact we need to at least have a discussion on the next item, and you all need to think about both of them.
And there's also, if the one park, is it Wallace Tatum that they're proposing the equestrian area? Which one?
Lanier Land.
If that goes forward and they build some kind of stables up there to do that, and with that park, why would we want to pay twice for something when he could just keep them up there?
Well, it's going to be years before that's built. So.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, that's one thing. The other thing is that we could get potentially real paying customers.
Yeah, we can rent it out, not to
the fact that he's not there frees up X number of stables for somebody to pay for.
And what if a new sheriff's elected and he doesn't want the horses and thinks they're a waste of money?
If that happens, then obviously, you know, this the next contract for Chestnutty expires on its own on 2014. I don't know if we're going to have any stables built anywhere before then.
Well, what about, you said it's going to come out of sheriff's budget, of course, eventually it comes out of our budget.
Sure it does.
Who's going to maintain, is there a yearly contract to maintain this building, Forsyth's budget now?
I would anticipate that in the next budget sent over from the sheriff's office, there will be a line item or some sort of a request for the funding, maintenance, construction.
Yeah, once you build it, it's yours. That's a weird way for him to get his thing done without coming to us first, it's very interesting.
Well, wait a minute, once he builds it, it's not his, if they come, this is a lease on the land, right? It's not an ownership of the land.
For how long is it?
Yeah, but the actual bricks and mortar would belong to the entity that built it unless.
Not when you make improvements, that becomes real property then, that's not a fixture anymore. You can't pick that building up and take it with you.
Depends on how your agreement reads.
Rent a house and fix it up.
Well, this wasn't prepared in the ordinary course.
That's what I was getting at.
The other thing is, are there any zoning considerations? I know it's on school land.
Which means there are none, but there are permitting obligations.
Well, but I guess what I'm saying is this something where we should attempt to imagine that there's not a school there, that it was some other kind of thing, and does a horse stable or barn or whatever this is going to be, do we have an obligation to consider that or not, would you say?
You could consider it, but you have no legal obligation.
How long is the lease, please?
Okay, we're on the next agenda item, so.
Which one, we keep bouncing around?
Well, we're on 22 right now. He's asking about the lease between the sheriff's office and the Board of Education with respect to this facility. The agreement becomes effective when signed by both parties and will remain in effect until June 30th, 2014.
Basically, we're talking about 21, and give them 7 officers, then we really approve in 22, because that's how you get 7 officers.
And to be fair, the lease also provides that either party may terminate upon 60 days' notice. So practically.
Why would we build a building?
That's just the mounted patrol.
Correct, that's wrong.
It is a mounted patrol, but.
So we're not adding.
Have you ever heard anybody building an improvement on a property that only does a year or 2 year lease?
No, but the school's going to pay for one, make 6.
Who would put their money into something like that and just give it away?
I think the expectation is, again, getting into this a little late, I think the expectation would be is they would be asked.
They get, school's going to pay for one, make 6. And then the school's going to have leased property to pay for 7.
No, nobody can.
So we're going to pay the school.
As county.
Well, they just leased it to us to build a building, we're not paying.
Counselor, would you recommend us invest money in something that on land that we don't own?
One additional.
And with a short lease.
Well, the sheriff's provided through his budget, of course, ultimate means we.
So that's the trade-off.
Yeah, trade-off is he gets 7 officers, and 21, we got 5 now.
Yes.
The school's going to pay for 1.
Yes.
And we're going to add 1 more through this lease purchase agreement with the school.
Yes.
To make a total of 7.
But it doesn't mean that we're going to increase approved positions, he would just have to take an approved position and make it an SRO?
Yes, he will either, come to you and put that in your, in his budget request.
Yeah, for a new person.
For a new person.
Well,
Or he will put it in.
I think it would be wise to assume that we're going to not add another person, but it would have to be an existing funded position.
But this reads of, he's going to be stationed at the schoolhouse.
Well, you have to take one of his existing deputies and convert him to an SRO. I don't think we need to add another position. He may not be asking.
You know the sheriff, sure he will.
Well, it's not said here. We're making an assumption that he wants to add somebody.
I know, but I'm saying that's the way this thing reads.
Well, what we need to do is specify, though, that if indeed we approve this, that we're not approving an additional funded position for an SRO.
Do you feel comfortable with the county spending money to build some kind of a structure on land we don't own and with such a short lease?
It depends on how much they're going to invest in it.
Right.
Right. And is that information given to us?
No.
Exactly. It's a really weird way of railroading us into this thing and making us do it.
Why don't we postpone it until the next work session?
Well, why can't we approve the first document, which does not necessarily, I don't see where it says that it's paid for by land.
The lease is 7 officers.
It references it back for the 7.
Well, okay, but here's the thing. We gave, we agreed to 5. Why? And let's just assume this was a numbers oversight, let's say by the school, or they realized another school had the same need as the other 5. Would we have said no to 7 in the first place?
If they want to work out a dharma, that's fine. The fact that we're going to build a structure on their land with a 1-year or 2-year lease.
Agreement number one doesn't say anything about how stuff gets paid for. So the issue to me is there a need for seven?
Greenwood does.
And would we have agreed to seven if it had been brought up in the first place? And my probable answer to that is yes.
Yes, we would have, but also want to make sure that we're not insinuating that we're adding funded positions to the budget. That if he wants to take two of his existing deputies and convert them to SROs versus whatever they may be doing now, that that's fine.
Assuming that that's what he did for the other five.
I don't care what he did for the other five.
Sorry.
We're not going to, we can't add two more deputies to the budget. That's what I'm saying.
Well, the school's going to pay for one.
Okay.
Well, I mean, we can't, we don't, it's not going to come out of budget, but it's number seven I'm worried about.
I just think that we need to specify that there's no additionally funded positions, that if he wants to convert deputies, he can. That's his problem.
Let me just go back to the statement by one of you made.
I agree.
I don't remember which one that says that the paragraph, the first agenda item does not reference the other item. It does. I mean, the second school resource officer indicates it'll be based on the IGA dated March 11th, 2011. That's the one that you all are grabbing.
Where is that in there?
It's in that paragraph about five lines down.
Right, where it says seven, it's on the index. 21, go back 21.
So they are linked. The two agenda items are linked.
Third from the bottom.
But again, if he wants to provide a seventh SRO.
Yes.
Out of existing funded positions, that's his prerogative.
Well, the March 11th agreement was prepared, presumably, and executed before the latest budget request. So
we're not approving another.
Yeah,
position.
We should know what's in the budget.
That's all I want to make sure. We're not approving another position.
But if we approve this and then approve the other,
you can't approve this.
That's
either
difficult
way.
To do.
Yeah, you can't. You need to write.
It is hard. They're tied together
because they reference each other.
They're meshed together.
They need to be cleaned up.
If you want to postpone it, that's fine. Again, this was brought because finance identified it and it made good sense.
So. Pleasure of the board is to
postpone to December 27th.
Go ahead and do them. If we can do
21 and 22.
21 and 22.
Yeah, and I guess what just, you know, so I'll say it. What I'm particularly interested in is the cost of the building that would go to house these.
To yep. Commissioner Levant's point, if we're going to enter into a lease that can be terminated within 60 days, is that a wise financial decision?
It's not. I would never with my personal money.
No size, no.
But if he wants to spend that money out of his existing budget,
I can't.
Then we do that. He can buy, he can build all he wants.
Yeah, but again, the trick is, the reason I'm bringing it to you is because there are indemnity obligations that I believe will ultimately fall to the county.
But I'm trying to make sure that you understand that if he wants to build it out of his existing budget.
Well, and the next year, budget goes up.
But I'm saying we can't, you know, we can't deny him building this thing if the lease is there. We can just.
He knows that that's why he's approached it in this roundabout way.
He's a constitutional officer. He can do that. We may not agree with it, but he can do it.
But is it not true that, let's say this had been for six, not seven, and let's forget about the land for a second, the lease and all that.
Yes.
The fact that the school's paying for number six, doesn't that mean that actually he's getting an increase to his budget?
Yeah, my expectation is that's a direct appropriation from the Board of Education to the Sheriff's Office. Yes.
Okay. So we have to do a budget amendment anyway to recognize the.
And that would be, I'm sure,
actually,
David will recognize.
He can do it, I think, on your own, can't you, Mr. Brown, now with some authority you were given?
With no match, that's
well, it
fit under
it's
that.
No,
we'll look at that. We'll do
it's
that.
School board's revenue and and their budgeting that matching revenue to the SRO because see during the summertime he's not an SRO, he moves to Lake Patrol or Park
Patrol.
I mean,
it says they're funded by South County School. Does it say partially funded or?
Right, well, if we need to do it in amendment,
in reality, the amount that they pay, does it cover? There are other benefits like health insurance and such. Or if you really ran the numbers, does it not cover those items?
Well, in the first, the original agreement to provide the SROs, there's a dollar amount stated. And for example, and the school board's paying 70% of the cost, not 100%. That dollar amount is $31,289 per officer. So all that tells me is what the school board's saying is the value of the consideration for this rental is $31,289.
Yeah, I was just going back even to last year's approval.
Right.
When you figure out the 70%, whatever your 100% number was, did that include the their benefits as well.
The 70, was it just wages only, or was it salaries?
That would equate to wages of $44,700, so it depends which officers are used and what the benefits are.
For DS2, that's going to...
I mean, it's a fixed amount in the agreement. It would vary depending on the officers assigned.
All right, I'm going to move that we postpone item number 21 to the December 27th meeting.
Second.
The motion is second. Any further discussion? Not, please vote on the motion. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, like sign. There are none. Item 21 is postponed. I'm going to move that we postpone item 22 to the December 27th work session.
Second.
No motion is second. Any discussion?
Just for my own purposes, when we bring this item back, what would you like me to bring back? The cost that has been invested on the school property today?
Well, and what this building may cost.
That's what I'm getting, the cost that's been invested out there.
Yeah.
Because this was in March, folks, so my expectation.
We've already built it.
I don't know.
Wow. Well, if that's already been done, there's not a whole lot we can do.
Yeah, I'm writing his money, his budget.
If he built it out of this year's budget, he can do that.
I think it was built out of
well,
the
Well, separate the difference between whether he's built it or whether you have to contract.
Just give some more information. Just covers, please.
We have a motion and a second. Any further discussion?
One question. Do we have to agree to the indemnity part?
No.
So we could just say...
No, I'm not going to put it in front of you. No. I mean, you could say no, but then he'll have to go back and rework that.
We have a motion and a second. Any further discussion? Not, please vote on the motion. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, like sign. There are none. Item 22 is postponed until December 27th.